So I noticed my Owen Wilson mug was missing today.
No.
Don't do that. Did you steal it? Or
no.
What?
You don't have an Owen Wilson
mug. I do have an Owen Wilson mug, yes.
I don't drink out of the mugs.
Well, it's gone this morning, so like...
Oh, no.
Well, I know you took it.
It's gone?
Let's look for it. Ladies! Who's ready to find love?
Love!
Yeah, let's hear it.
I mean...
When I saw you three...
Wait,
slashing those tires with that Owen Wilson mug,
no.
knew you were perfect for our show. Now, we are going to have to do...
What show?
A few little... Same questions to the end. A few little tweaks to make you TV ready. Starting with you... Lose the bangs.
Bitch.
You...
Yeah.
Change something. Anything. Just change something. You... we'll fix it in post. Alright, now who's ready to date some women?
Men! With penises.
Can we, like, talk about this real quick?
I don't think it's a good idea.
I think it's fine.
No, I think like they're gonna make us look like fools, and we don't need that out in the world.
I don't think like we would ever do anything.
Like I think our dating lives are already hard enough. Well, why add publicity to it?
I think we need to get out there, put ourselves out there, put ourselves on film, so that we can open ourselves up to love.
Think for yourself.
No, you need
you fucking bitch.
Oh,
people, it's not on the screen.
No, I mean,
what do you mean?
Because you don't need to be on TV.
Patches, we'll do it.
That's what I like to hear.
What's up, guys? I'm Patches, your host, and today we are going to find out if three women in the apartment right behind us are available for love. They are three of the most ineligible women in Iowa City. Not because they're taken, but because they're undateable. Come along with us as we delve deep into the human psyche and find out, can love be brewed in a bottle? Come on!
This is a house tour?
Yeah, give me 1 second.
Wake up.
Hey!
Ashley, they're here. Good morning.
Good morning. Ready whenever.
Okay, cool. Hi, I'm Mac. Mackenzie, if you will.
Okay, should I start? Do I look all right?
You're kind of wasting valuable, like...
Oh, I'm Ashley. I live here with Mac. Sophie's here, too.
I'm Sophie.
So, this is our apartment. Welcome in. Here's Sophie. Okay. Shot blast! for Pepto-Bismol and stuff. Over here, Billy Ray.
I'm majoring in forensic sciences. Do you like want to hear about it? So I work with dead bodies.
I'm an open major, open to anything.
What do you mean by that?
You know. All right.
I pay the least amount. Ashley pays like the medium price, and Sophie pays the most.
I pay the majority.
Yes. Well, look at that. Double Owen. Am I right?
Yeah.
So we've got all our chairs kind of here. Sophie, did you move some of these? They were kind of set up.
I kind of made it like into like an avant-garde kind of pile.
Yeah.
Well, come along. This is where the magic happens. But this is my cupboard, and I don't really know how to turn on the lights, but Ashley does. Ashley, do you know how to turn on the lights in here?
Up the... Yeah.
Do I pull?
Oh, yeah.
Down?
Yes, downward towards the... Yeah.
That's my stuff. My backpack is my pillow, and it's really not too small because I sleep in the fetal position anyway, so it doesn't bother me. No, I like to eat it by the spoonful.
Ashley and I met on Facebook. It's how, like, most people find their roommates here.
I found them.
This is my room, but it's too messy right now to be shown.
Yes. This is my humble abode. This is my space. We got three different kind of lights up there. It really helps with my meditation sometimes. I do meditate. It's kind of an upside down. I'm like, shh, and I go upside down and I meditate. It's really good for blood flow and brain and stuff like that. Santa. This was a gift I think we got for Sophie last Christmas. Yeah. We got Santa.
And I told Ashley to put it in here because, you know, I spend a lot of time looking into this room, so it's just nice to see it.
You look into this room?
And that's the house tour. Just us three gals.
Now let me ask you a question. Are you a feminist? Are you an ardent feminist? Let me pose that to you, huh? Cat got your tongue?
Please
take a
have
seat.
Have a seat.
I'll sit when I'm getting ready.
You must be Patches?
Well, duh, yeah. What gave it away? Thanks, Sherlock.
Patch. Tell me a bit about your project in...
You've seen men.
Mm-hmm.
Too many men, almost. We've kind of seen enough. We've also seen women. Beautiful. Beautiful women. But what we haven't seen... Can you all kind of open the floor? Any guesses? Ugly ones. I mean, for God's sake, it's 2023. Wake up. What I'm about to propose will radicalize the landscape of television as you know it. Liberal, diverse, wokeness, inclusion, neoliberal radical feminism. Obnoxious. Not too easy on the eyes. Stinkers, almost. Inclusivity. Well, pick up your toys.
Sorry about that.
You made a mess.
Please go.
I happened to stumble across three beans in my travels. Poor imitations, but women nonetheless. Grotesque. Outrageously ill-mannered. That's as American as it gets.
Hags.
Thank you. You're picking up fast. Broads. Crones. Old crones. Half Mexican. Full ginger. Another half Mexican. Equals a whole. As soon as I caught a whiff of their stench, I knew that they were going to be big. Unfortunately for this film, we do need men to associate with these women, and we can see their dynamics play out on screen. You have them, we need them.
What kind of male body count are we talking about here?
Upwards of an army.
You're talking about actors, or as we say in the business, the talent as a producer. I have quite a bit of access to
well, I
actors.
Sure hope so.
Especially if you're interested in one man in particular.
One man? Who could this... It's kind of looking for a group, an army almost.
Well, he is an army unto himself. Christian. Bale? Ring a bell?
Bells are going off. Bells are ringing.
Bells are going off. That's
the
what
bell
I like to
is
hear.
Tolling.
Not quite the Christian Bale, but for all intents and purposes, on screen and off screen, to sometimes on the street he'll be mistaken, but you know, movie magic.
So you're saying a man who is essentially the essence of Christian and yet almost not Christian at all.
Essentially.
Yeah, we'll take him. We'll take this pseudo Bale.
Well, I can get him. Probably on the horn this afternoon.
We're gonna need 10 grand as well. I know that won't be a problem for you, but just kind of as an afterthought. I kind of see something.
You maybe.
It's fine for me.
Do you have Venmo? The computer's not working right now. There will be profit to be returned.
I find it gauche to discuss.
Gauche indeed. Yes. Yes.
Wish I could say it's been a pleasure, but it's been productive, and that's. For
yeah, well.
So I'll bid you a day. Wire it to me.
Okay.
Got to hear it. Got to hear the concert.
What do you want? just not want to watch a movie?
I have something I'd like to do instead.
And you and your homies might be lying in chat. I really need to trip, but I gotta look. As they croak, I see myself in the pencil smoke. Fool, I'm a tiny bee, the little homies wanna be. On my knees in the night, saying prayers in the streetlight. It's land and most their life, living in a gangster's paradise. What?
Hi. I'm Steven Smarmson, and I'm the executive producer on this production. I consider myself to be an ardent feminist, and as a feminist, I've known a lot of extremely obnoxious and very unattractive women. And I have to say that without a doubt, Mac, Sophie, and Ashley are the most obnoxious and unattractive women I have ever met. And as such, I think they're perfect. The overall repugnance of these three women was really enough for us to cast them. But there was also, you know, the added bonus of the diversity factor. I mean, we have two half-Mexicans and two gingers, or half-gingers, I guess. I think one of them might be actually a full ginger. You know, I think here in Hollywood, a lot of executive producers, they look like me. They're white men. I think it's extremely important that we bring in other voices, that we elevate voices, that we, you know, we tell these stories. You know, it's 2023. We need to wake up.
What?
Good morning.
Good morning. What the junk is that? What are you doing?
I'm making breakfast. It's bread and peanut butter.
Oh. You know, if I'm allergic to peanuts, you just killed me. You took that knife, you held me up against the wall, you slit my throat, boom, blood everywhere, psh. I'm dead. And it's on you.
No, I hear you, but you are not allergic to peanuts.
You don't know that.
You ate a Nutter Butter yesterday.
It's just peanut flavor. It's not peanut.
Exposure thing.
No, no!
Smell it. Smell it. I swear.
No.
You'll be fine.
Sophie has, like, a fear of peanut allergy, and it doesn't really make sense. I get yelled at a lot for making peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, America's favorite lunch. It's nuts.
Sophie has this peanut butter allergy thing. She's afraid of having a peanut allergy.
And I get it, because I too am scared of almost everything. I mean, revolving doors stress me out a lot. It's almost a mockery of what real anxiety is, which is being scared all the time of everything.
I said, no, take those peanuts away, like, keep them for yourself, and I'll get like a healthy fat some other way. Yeah, I just think it's really mean of them to not, like, respect my, like, potential peanut allergy.
In all seriousness, peanut butter allergies are an extremely serious issue, and I'm glad that there's a film being produced now about exactly that. But many schools, for example, they continue to allow peanut butter sandwiches, Reese's. I mean, there's a proliferation of different types of Reese's nowadays. You know, there's the pretzel Reese's, they put chips in Reese's. You know, imagine that, mixing chips with peanut butter in a candy bar, and you have many children who might not even know it, but they might have a peanut allergy. They even have you seen this? I saw this the other day, I was shocked. In the store, Reese's Pieces, a derivative of Reese's, inside a Reese's peanut butter cup. I mean, how dumb can you be?
You want nuts? Yeah, I'll take some.
Okay. Oh, are you
gonna
sure you can have
the nuts? Yeah, those are peanuts.
Okay. Yeah. You can just get in there if you want. Yeah, just.
I'm not gonna touch the sides, okay?
No,
I'm not
you can
gonna touch the
okay.
sides.
No, that's really helpful.
I think I touched the sides a little.
You did, but this is an operation.
Are you supposed to suck on these?
Where do you get that shirt? I like it. I think it's cute, kind of kiwi.
It's my favorite moment of live television.
Really?
The slap? Yeah.
Hey, no.
Oh, you, sorry,
it's kind of violent. Can you, like, take a few steps back?
Please? I'm going to.
Okay.
You know yeah. Remember when Chris Rock said that?
I wish you would, like, feel nervous about, like, these types of things, because, like, this is mortifying for you. Like, really embarrassing. Have you guys ever heard of Steve Buscemi?
Yeah, I know him.
But, like, I love Steve.
Yeah, that makes sense.
You think he's a good actor, but do you have a crush on Steve Buscemi?
I love Steve.
Well, who else do you like love?
Like, you know, Jack Nicholson.
So you are almost a grave rock.
Yeah.
Some may rob the cradle, others rob the grave.
I've never been convicted of robbing
the grave. No, I'm not.
And I'd like you to stop bringing that up.
Criminal charges, I'm not. At what point is too old?
Like, once they're dead, like, don't do anything with them. You know what I mean? Like,
well, obviously.
Yeah.
This is interesting conversation.
A crime if you did anything with a dead person afterwards.
Yeah, so I'm saying don't. But, like, right before you can.
I still...
Like, you can, like, even when they're on the brink of death.
Okay.
Or when they're dead.
I just don't...
I'm trying to just wrap my head around. They closed at different angles so that you can, like, keep people from looking in. Do you see that cloud? It looks swirly. That cloud looks swirly.
I kind of wish it was a tornado.
What if it's storm? No!
Because then it would suck you up and then
look, beyond you, there's a cloud and it's swirling.
You know what happens when people get sucked into tornadoes, Ashley?
What?
You're a goner. It's going to take you and all your nervous energy away and it's going to go, whoa, whoa, and then throw you.
I don't really think
that's
you
not
should
funny.
Be talking.
That's not funny. What happened? What if it was like, what if I was like swept away and then there was a cow in there and then I had to touch butts with a cow.
What if you did more than touch butts with a cow? What if you got pregnant with a cow baby? But then, midair, you have a cow miscarriage.
What's so funny about that? That's not funny.
And then you get so nervous because you're like, oh, are they going to arrest me like for accidentally like aborting my cow baby? That's really funny.
Why do you think we're gonna die?
Here's why I think we're gonna die. It's because you're not gonna be prepared enough.
Oh my god. You're so right.
If a tornado comes, we're just gonna go in the basement.
We don't have a basement.
We'll go to the bottom floor.
But what if there are, like, creepy men down there? What if they're like, ah, come inside, I've got candy for you in a tornado.
In every scenario, you die. So,
honestly, that's fine.
That's a box. I like to keep things in it. Right now it's empty. I have a secretary who helps to empty it. Over here. My nephew made that. He's in art school. Good kid. Yeah, hi, is this Mr. Sundance? Or Miss Sundance? Yeah, I was just calling to ask about the entry fees for your films. Is that like a kind of a is that how much it cost? Okay, thank you very much. I think, you know, this is a very relatable circumstance. You know, I, for one, was stuck in a revolving door for several days. And, well, they've grown back now, but I had to eat my own fingernails.
Thank you. strength to carry on. And then a hero comes along.
Hello? Reed! How are you? Yeah, did you get my email? No. No, they're not. They're not that unattractive, no.
I can't hear you.
What?
Put the window down. Okay. Hours two.
Well, who might you be?
I'm with Steven.
Steven from, Steven?
Yeah.
Schmork?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know how to say it.
So you must be Christian Bale?
Yeah, I get that a lot. I mean, you're not the first, but yeah, pretty much.
Well, I suppose beggars can't be choosy. We really appreciate you coming here today. From the bottom of our hearts, we have been searching far and wide for a talent such as yourself. Now tell me, what got you into the acting business?
Nepotism, a little bit.
The truth is, no one else would accept the role. I can tell you got chutzpah, kid. In fact, show me some of the chutzpah right now. Give me a line. Come on, let's go. Grief.
Any line?
Show me grief.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
Show me Christian Bale.
I've abandoned my child! I've abandoned my...
So here's the rub. You're gonna go on dates with three women. All at once. And they're all gonna... You're gonna be the apple of their eyes, so to speak. And they're gonna take a... I don't know if you're familiar with a chemistry test.
Yeah, I've done it
1,000 times. Hit us with one with a sloth. Let's see how good you jive.
Hey, baby mom. Looking good tonight. Silent type, huh? Okay. I fuck with that.
Cut, cut! My God. You know what? You're hired. You're perfect. Monday, 4 in the morning, let's go date some women.
I'm trying to do, like, I saw a trick online, I'm trying to do it, and you're like, it's like a, put your legs, and then you, like, roll on it, like, something like that.
Okay,
yeah.
I just texted the guy, and I have a date on Friday.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, wait.
I also
have a date.
Friday. We can all go to the same place on Friday and, like, we can make sure, like, none of us gets, like, kidnapped by these men. Oh, this is so exciting.
Friday
date time! Okay, I think this is the final sweater, like a necklace.
I like it.
You look chic.
Very,
yeah.
You look like a slut.
To be honest, I don't think Sophie knows what slut means. She called my dad a slut once.
Slut. Sophie loves your tits or Sophie loves your top.
Okay, so if we're all having someone over tonight, we need to maybe figure out, like, protection, things like that.
Yeah. And I have extra for you guys if you want it, but I take a diva cup
and I put it upside down. That way it catches everything that wants to go up and it goes whoop and then goes back down.
All right, so we need to talk about rules for these dates, right? Because we can't all have the same person in here at the same time.
Actually, guys, we might want to be practicing how we're going to get someone to go into.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, don't worry. I think the tone of this room is, like, cunty, if you will.
A little bit, yeah. It's, like, kind of, like, sister, like, the tone.
Yeah.
I feel like tone is, like, such a loaded word, like, to figure out the tone.
Like, what's tone, what's mood.
I feel kind of royal.
Okay. So, he's supposed to be coming any minute now. This is what I'm wearing for the date. Okay, that probably is him.
Oh my God, hey, welcome in. This is my apartment, but I'm gonna go grab my wallet real quick and we can head out.
Okay, yeah, sounds good.
Hey, oh, so happy you're here. So you can just like hang out in here. I actually have to go grab my deodorant. Okay.
We'll
smell it.
Yeah.
But so you can just hang out in there. I'll be right back though.
All right.
Don't move a muscle.
Okay.
Hey, stranger, what's
up?
Oh, I'm so good. I see you're in the entryway. Want to take things into the cupboard?
What do you mean?
The cupboard.
Oh, hey, no, don't. You don't have to worry about her. So, I'm ready to go. Whenever you are, I got my deodorant, natural, Schmidt's.
Deodorant,
what are you talking about?
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you guys met my date, but we're gonna go head out now.
This is covered, guy.
I don't know what you mean by that.
The
details.
No, you said that your guy looked like Christian Bale.
Does he not look like Christian
Bale? I
was gonna say, like, dragon.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I'm telling, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, like
that's
that,
exactly.
Okay, I can kind of see it.
Do it.
Yeah,
see,
I'm like, oh. Okay, say something. Say anything. Okay, and I said there was something Simpsonian about his voice. Like,
okay.
Hey, homie, like that kind of thing.
Like, more of like a, hey, like a.
Yeah, it's a little bit lower. It's a little bit lower.
Yeah.
So,
hey, yeah.
What, we've just been talking to, like, the same guy?
Ladies, I'm telling you, there's enough of me to go around.
I'll get a load of this guy. What? No, for real, let's go to the cupboard now. Let's...
Huh?
Wait. Oh.
That was the worst. Not... exactly what I thought I'd be doing with my career. And their apartment smells awful. They all have this weird, like twinge in their eye. I mean, especially the cupboard girl, but I'm not gonna hold that against her. I feel like it's beyond her control, but I just didn't wanna be there. You don't want to be around him. This is the last thing I'll do for my uncle. Not the first time he's taken advantage of me. Not like in a weird way. Just like, career-wise. I gotta make a call.
No, I'm sorry. They weren't that bad. Oh, I mean, come on, Reed. I mean, it's a family gathering. Family, you know? No, I called them. They said that it was $65. And, no, I mean, yeah, of course you're worth it, but... No, it's not... Look, Reed. Can you just let me talk for a second? I'm sorry, okay? I just don't want this to come between us. I mean, it's Thanksgiving, you know? Your family.
Steven. I hope you sleep with one eye open. You know why? 'Cause I'm gonna be there
watching. I don't like my feelings getting toyed with, but I mean, it was a good learning experience. I can probably improve in the future and hopefully grow from this.
I will not be growing from this experience. I will be shrinking. I'll be shrinking to the size of a penny so I can fall from the sky and land on Samuel Stephen Schmarmison. What kind of name is that? And you know what? I think he's allergic to peanut butter. For real. Actually. Him and his freaking nephew can go mind their own business. I will not be growing.
Don't let yourself go. Cause everybody cries. And everybody hurts.
Yep.
Sometimes.
Guys, that was rough.
Yep. Never been rejected like that.
Really?
Never.
It's what are we gonna do?
It's not like he was even one of the better looking ones anyway.
No, so he was like, ugly.
He was better looking than us, so.
No, his face was like too angular.
No, it was, that was like the peak.
We should have known. No one would stop a revolving door for a woman. Not today.
Well, maybe the real man is the friends that we made along the way.
What are you?
And everybody hurts.
Don't throw your hand.
Hi there. I'm Samuel Schmarmerson. This is my office. I'm a producer here in Hollywood. As you can see, it's a pretty busy place. I've got, you know, important messages, for example. You know, a funnel. Just in case. Well, I'm actually not allowed to have this. Not in the state of California. Anyways, there's a whole lot of stuff here that you probably don't know how to use as a layperson. But as a producer, there's a lot of things you gotta know.